당근마켓 많이들 이용하실 텐데요. 네. 당근마켓, 그리고 뭐, 인스타, 밴드, 뭐, 페이스북 여러 가지 툴을 이용해서 소식을 전하시고, 뭐, 홍보를 하실 텐데, 당근마켓의 특징이라고 하면, 소셜미디어 같은 경우는 사용자들이 지인 기반으로 서로 알리기 때문에 지역 기반으로 뭔가 정보가 전달되진 않아요, 많이들. 네, 당근마켓은 비지인 기반이지만 지역 정보 기반으로 전달이 되기 때문에 그 지역에 해당하는 사람들에게 정보가 잘 전달될 수 있는 특징이 있는 것 같습니다. 그래서 사용자도 굉장히 많고, 그리고 많이 전달이 될수 있어서 좋은 툴이라고 생각을 하고 있습니다. 그래서 오늘, 소개는 지금 보여드리는 순서대로 진행하려고 합니다. 어떻게 당근마켓에서 홍보를 할수 있을지에 대해서 비즈니스 프로필 생성하는 것에 대한 방법과 그리고 어떻게 소식 작성할지 그리고 비즈니스 프로필을 또 어떻게 관리할지에 대해서 말씀드리고요. 이후에 궁금한 점 질문 답변 받도록 하겠습니다. 프로필 생성, 비즈니스 프로필 생성인데요. 밑에 메뉴 보시면 나의 당근이라고 메뉴가 있습니다. 홈, 뭐 동네 생활, 내 근처, 채팅, 나의 당근, 나의 당근이라는 곳에 들어가면 이런 메뉴들이 쭉 뜨고 있고요. 비즈니스 프로필 관리를 누르게 되면 이 비즈니스 프로필이 뜨게 됩니다. 이 비즈니스 프로필은 뭐냐 하면 카페 같은 거라고 생각하시면 돼요. 근데 이제 여기 비즈니스니까 비즈니스형 카페 같은 느낌으로 이해해 주시면 될것 같고, 이것들을 만들게 되면 내가 뭐 카페지기처럼 이제 홈페이지 관리자처럼 그 역할을 하게 되는 겁니다. 그리고 이걸 어떻게 만드는지 간단하게 소개를 드려보면, 이미 만드셨으면 이렇게 요 화살표 누르시면 새로 비즈니스 프로필을 만드실 수 있고, 만드시지 않았으면 아마 비즈니스 프로필을 만들라는 메뉴가 뜰 거예요. 그래서 비즈니스 프로필을 다음 단계 쭉 따라가서 프로필을 만드시면 되고, 여기도 지역 기반이기 때문에 지역 주소를 넣어야 되는데, 여기에는 클럽이 그 모임하는 장소를 넣으시면 될것 같고요. 그리고 뭐 어떤 주제로 하느냐, 뭐 영업해야다, 그리고 프로필에 나가는 사진, 그리고 저희 모임했을 때 찍었던 사진들을 올려주시면 됩니다. 이렇게 해서 비즈니스 프로필이 만들어지면 이런 화면이 보여지게 되고, 이후부터는 소식을 작성해서 지역 주민한테 이제 소식을 전파할 수 있습니다. 저희 모임은 서현동에서 모임을 하고 있어서 반경 한 5에서 한 10km 정도의 거리에 있는 분들한테 소식이 전달되는 것 같아요. 저희가 이렇게 프로필 만들고 소식을 이렇게 제목, 내용, 그다음에 사진에서 넣게 되면 소식 작성을 이렇게 보통은 하는데, 제목 넣고 언제 한다, 그리고 기본적으로 뭐 토스트마스터즈 모임에 대한 소개를 간단하게 하고, 그다음에 저희 모임 장소, 시간 정보들을 하고, 저희는 이번 주에 하는 주제에 대해서도 간단하게 소개를 드립니다. 이렇게 세 가지 콘텐츠를 담고 이제 사진을 넣어서 소식을 만들어서 올리게 되면, 아까 말씀드렸던 그런 반경 5에서 10km에 있는, 저희 서현이니까 뭐 백현동 판교 쪽에 있는 곳, 그다음에 서현 정자 뭐 미금 조금 용인까지 가면 죽전까지 해서 쭉 퍼져서 소식이 전달되더라고요. 그런데 저희가 판교 토스트마스터라는 모임으로 하니까 판교 쪽에 있는 분들이 좀 많이 오시긴 합니다. 그래서 소식을 작성을 하면 여기에서 이제 그 소식이 얼마나 전달됐는지, 184명한테 이 소식이 전달됐다라는 것들이 통계 지표 같이 나오게 되고, 근데 뭐 최대로 할수 있는 거는 81,899명까지 전달할 수 있다라고 하는데, 저희는 무료로 쓰는 거기 때문에 소식 작성, 비즈니스 프로필 생성, 소식 작성은 무료로 할수 있어서 이런 정보들을 전달하는 것들은 무료로 할수 있고, 근데 만약에 돈을 낸다고 하면 8만 명까지도 쫙 확대할 수 있다, 이렇게 이제 광고를 사용하도록 권하고 있긴 합니다. 근데 그렇지 않아도 충분히 활용할 수 있, 유용하게 쓰실 수 있습니다. 저희는 매주 작성하지는 않고요, 한두 주, 아니면 세 주에 한 번씩 글을 올려요. 근데 한번 글을 올려놓으면, 이건 제가 한 지난주에 캡처해 놓은 건데, 한 100, 두 주, 한두 주 지나면 100명, 한 200명 정도 보게 되고, 시간이 계속 지나더라도 과거에 올렸던 글들이 계속 조회수가 늘어나더라고요. 이게 9월 23일에 했던 건 346명이 받고, 8월 1일에 올렸던 476명. 이게 시간 지날수록 계속 보여지는 것 같더라고요. 소식이 과거에 있던 것도 보여지고, 최신 것도 올려지니까 어떤 사람은 과거 거를 최근에 보고 오기도 하고, 뭐 최신 거를 보고 오기도 하고, 이렇게 조금 정보들이 많이 계속 노출이 되다 보니까 매주 올리지 않아도 충분히 많은 손님들이 오시는 것 같습니다. 그리고 어디에 보여지느냐, 저희도 이거 좀 확인해 보다 보니까, 홈에 이렇게 거래하기 목록 같은 것들이 이제 피드로 쭉 뜨는데 거기에 아마 이런 글들이 뜨는 것 같아요. 제가 이제 저희 홍보하는 그런 글이 뜬 것을 캡처하지 못해서 제가 편집해서 넣었는데 대략 이런데 피드 안에 하나씩 하나씩 카드 형태로 들어가는 것 같아요. 이렇게 들어가는 경로가 하나 있고 또 하나는 검색을 해서 들어오실 수 있는데 영어 회화로 검색을 하게 되면 저희 모임이 이제 검색 결과로 나오게 되더라고요. 근데 아까 보여드렸던 것처럼 여러 개 글들이 같이 검색되잖아요. 그래서 이런 것들이 다 홈을 통해서 소식이 전달되고 있고 검색 결과도 나온다. 그래서 이두 가지 메인 경로를 통해서 사람들이 들어오게 되는 것 같아요. 그러면 제가 저번에 한번 당근마켓을 홍보하는 방법들을 소개했을 때는 동네 생활이라는 거를 이용해서 하는 것들을 소개해 드렸었어요. 저희도 처음에 이거를 시작을 했다가 이걸 매번 하다 보니까 이것 통해서도 많이 들어오시긴 했었는데 그래도 아까 비즈니스 프로필 생성 후 소식 작성하는 거랑 차이점이라고 하면 여기는 내가 소식을 하나 올리면 계속 이렇게 새로운 소식들이 계속 들어오면 이게 뒤로 밀려요. 계속해서 보여지기가 좀 어려운 구조 같더라고요. 그리고 여기 안에서도 뭐 모임이란 걸또 만들어서 뭐 사람들 간에 모임할 수 있도록 하는 것들을 만들고 사람들은 홍보할 수도 있긴 한데 여기는 뭐 체계적으로 비즈니스 프로필을 생성해서 소식들이 한 곳에 쌓이고 그뭐 단골 관리 뭐 회원 관리 같은 것들을 하는 메뉴까지는 없는 것 같아요. 그래서 여러 가지 기능을 이용해서 쓸 수도 있지만 그냥 비즈니스 프로필로 관리하는 게 조금 더 체계적으로 관리할 수 있고 효율적으로 전달되는 것 같아서 그거를 쓰고 있습니다. 이것도 써보셔도 되는데 이제 여러 가지를 같이 쓰게 되면 손이 많이 가니까 하나만 해도 괜찮지 않을까라고 생각이 듭니다. 그리고 이제 사람들에게 소식이 전했으면 그 사람들이 이 소식을 보고 저희한테 컨택을 하기 시작을 해요. 그러면 이 메뉴에 보면 채팅, 네 번째 탭, 채팅이란 탭에 들어오면 일반과 비즈니스가 있는데 비즈니스 탭으로 들어와서 여기 손님들이 소식을 보고 먼저 문의를 하면 여기에 리스트에 뜨게 됩니다. 그래서 뭐 에임하이란 분이 먼저 말을 거셔서 이렇게 대화를 이렇게 쭉 했었는데 이런 식으로 먼저 뭐 이번 주 모임 하나요? 이렇게 물어보시면 저희가 매번 일단은 기본적인 정보에 대해서는 템플릿으로 만들어서 답변을 드리고 있고 그다음에 뭐 주차가 되나요? 어디로 와야 되나요? 뭐 이런 것들은 개별적으로 답변을 드립니다. 근데 여기도 비즈니스 프로필을 생성하고 관리자를 여러 명을 둘수 있거든요. 그래서 혼자 다 대응하기 어려울 때는 이제 뭐 VP, PR, 뭐 BPM 같이 들어와서 대응을 해 드리면 빠르게 빠르게 좀 문의하신 분들을 이제 소개를 드리고 안내할 수 있을 것 같아요. 여기에 템플릿으로 답변을 드리고 여러 가지 대화들을 하면서 이분들이 궁금증을 풀어주는 역할들을 요 비즈니스 채팅의 비즈니스 탭에서 하실 수 있다. 그리고 여기에 있는 분들이랑 계속 대화했던 기록은 여기 남아 있으니까 나중에 확인하실 수도 있어요. 제가 답변을 하던 뭐 다른 분이 관리자가 답변하던 동일하게 그냥 이 색깔로 표시가 돼 구분되거든요. 이렇게 이제 소통하는 내용들을 확인하실 수 있고요. 그리고 이분들이한테 좀 게스트로 참여하셨던 분들 실제 모임에 참여하셨던 분들한테 후기를 한번 요청을 해드린 적인데 그분이 작성해 주셔서 이게 조금 유용한 것 같더라고요. 아까 이제 비즈니스 프로필을 만들면 이 사람들이 이 화면을 또 많이 보게 되는데 이 후기가 달려 있으면 이 클럽에서 활동했던 경험들을 여기서 나눌 수 있으니까 이런 글들이 또 홍보할 때 도움이 되는 것 같아요. 그래서 게스트분들이 참여했으면 뭐 돌아가실 때 혹시 번거롭지 않으시다면 당근마켓의 비즈니스 프로필에 후기 좀 남겨달라고 하면 이게 또 다른 홍보 도구로 좀 사용될 수 있을 것 같습니다. 요것들을 이용하시는 게좀 도움이 될것 같고요. 그리고 여기 이 비즈니스 프로필 안에 단골 관리라는 메뉴가 있습니다. 단골이라는 거는 여기 이 클럽 저희 비즈니스 프로필에 관심을 갖고 있어서 저희가 새로운 소식을 올리면 소식을 받을 수 있는 분들이라고 보시면 돼요. 소식을 받을 수 있는 분들이 지금 128명이 돼서 저희가 소식을 올리면 이분들한테는 기본적으로 카드가 꽂히는 것 같습니다. 그래서 저희가 올릴 때마다 실제 모임에 참석은 하지 않았지만 뭐 글을 쓰진 않았지만 이분들이 관심 갖고 계속 보시고 있으면 글을 올릴 때마다 이 내용들을 하실 수 있으니까 그때 다시 컨택을 하시는 경우도 있더라고요. 그래서 여기에 단골 리스트가 쭉 뜨는데 거기 보면 뭐 단골 알림을 킨 사람, 여기 뭐 채팅 단골 알림 있으면 채팅도 하고 단골 알림도 한 사람. 그러니까 먼저 당근마켓으로 메시지로 문의하셨던 분들은 이렇게 구분이 되어 있다고 보시면 될것 같아요. 그래서 이분을 딱 클릭해서 가면 과거에 어떻게 대화했는지 확인하실 수 있습니다. 그리고 또 하나는 저희 단골들 뭐 관리하는 거에 이분들에 대해서 메모 같은 것들을 해놓으면 나중에 이분들이랑 대화했던 내용들이라든지 이분이 나중에 어떻게 안내를 하면 좋을지 같은 것들을 적어놓을 수 있어서 이런 것들 메모 같은 기능, 요 화살표 버튼을 눌러서 기입을 해놓으시면 나중에 관리하시기 좀 수월하실 것 같아요. 그리고 이제 아까 조회수를 뭐몇회 했다 이런 것들 볼수 있지만 시계열로 어떤 시점에 어떻게 많이 조회됐는지 이제 그런 그 방문 통계 같은 것들을 확인하실 수 있어요. 저희 뭐이 판교 토스마스 PGTM 요 당근마켓 비즈니스 프로필에 어느 시점에 얼마나 많이 그 사람들이 왔었는지에 대한 것들을 통계를 볼수 있는데 거기 위치는 여기 우상단에 줄세줄 있는 거 눌러서 이제 펼쳐보면 이게 방문 통계가 있고요. 그러면 기간을 설정해서 어떻게 방문자들이 들어왔었는지를 확인하실 수 있습니다. 그리고 방문 경로도 이제 어떤 경로를 통해 많이 왔느냐, 뭐 홈을 통해 왔느냐, 뭐 기타 아니면 검색 뭘로 왔느냐 이 경로들을 확인하실 수 있고 그리고 네. 총 기간별로 총 방문 고객 수, 단골 고객 수 이제 이런 수치들을 확인하실 수 있습니다. 그리고 네, 그리고 검색을 통해서 들어왔다고 하면 어떤 키워드로 검색을 주로 했는지 그래서 내가 만약에 다시 소식을 올릴 때는 어떤 키워드를 넣어서 하는 게좀더 효과적인지를 좀 여기서 확인할 수 있을 것 같아요. 그리고 마지막으로는 지역별로 어떤 지역에 있는 사람들이 많이 방문했는지. 그래서 저희는 아까 판교라는 이름을 달고 있어서 그런지 백현동, 운준동, 뭐 판교동, 삼평동 여기가 다 판교에 있는 동이거든요. 여기 분들이 가장 많이 오셨어요. 아마 카드가 꽂혀서 보여질 텐데 판교 토스트마스터 하니까 판교에 있는 분들이 더 많이 관심 갖고 들어오신 것 같습니다. 이렇게 그 지역명을 어떻게 쓰느냐에 따라서 카드에 반응하는 사람들의 그런 지역이 좀 달라지는 것 같습니다. 그래서 대략 제가 설명드릴 내용은 이제 어떻게 비즈니스 프로필을 생성하고 관리를 하는지에 대해서 설명을 드렸고 어떻게 소통하고 관리하는지 그리고 이분들이랑 어떻게 커뮤니케이션에서 잘 이끌어 줄지 이런 것들을 좀 간단하게 설명드렸는데 혹시 제가 설명드린 내용 관련해서 궁금하신 점 있으면 질문 받도록 하겠습니다. 너무 순식간에 지나가서 네.
주영님 손 드셨습니다.
아, 네네. 제가 다 얼굴을 못 보고 있어서 말씀 주십시오.
그 내용을 포스팅하는 거는 제한이 있나요? 주 1회 내지는 더 이상도 가능한가요?
아, 제한이 딱히 있지 않은 것 같습니다. 제한은 없는 것 같고요. 저희가 주기를 누리님이 지금 관리해 주고 있는데 제가 누리님한테 인수인계 해드리면서 누리님 매주 올리지 마세요. 힘들어요. 이렇게 얘기를 드렸거든요. 그래서 한두 주, 세 주에 한 번씩 올리는 게 조금 좋은 것 같습니다. 너무 많이 와도 저희 클럽이 한 평균 12명 내외로 오시는데 거기 게스트분 비중이 너무 많으면 대응하기 조금 어려워서 한번 네 분이 오셨을 때는 굉장히 정신없이 이제 대응하냐고 힘들었던 기억이 있어서 약간 주기를 두고 있습니다. 네, 숨 마이야,
트위터인데 질문해도 될까요?
네, 수마야님 먼저 손을 드신 것 같긴 한데,
수마야님 하시죠.
네, 먼저 하시고 그 다음에 질문 받겠습니다.
네. 저는 이제 며칠 됐는데 방금 그 미팅 룸이 우리 열렸어요. 채팅이. 근데
네.
이제 사람이 들어올 때마다 우리 이제 문자 보내려고 하고 있긴 한데 근데 이거는 새로운 사람 들어오면은 자꾸 보내야 되는 건가요? 아니면은 먼저 보냈던 그 문자 그들이 볼수 있는지 그거
아,
궁금해요.
네네. 이게 저희가 먼저 잠깐만요. 단골 리스트에 이게 사람들이 있지만 저희가 먼저 다 대화를 시작할 수 없어요. 그분들이 저희한테 말을 걸어줘야지 그제서야 걸수 있거든요. 단골이더라도. 그러니까 이게 단골했다고 막 무작정 막 연락하고 그런 것들이 부담스러울 수 있으니까 관심 있는 사람이 연락하도록 하는 방식으로 하는 것 같습니다.
아,
그래서
네,
연락
감사합니다.
올 때만 답변하시면 될것 같아요.
아, 네, 감사합니다.
케이트님,
아,
지금.
예. 제가 그 당근을 자충우돌 하면서 좀 써봐서
네.
저는 이제 처음에 프로필 관리를 써봤다가 당근 모임이 생겼더라고요. 그래서 저는
네네.
이제 모임 쪽으로 접근을 했는데 오히려 이제 오늘 발표해 주신 분께서는 모임보다는 프로필 관리 쪽에서 접근하는 게좀더 효과적인 것 같다 이런 의미로 제가 이해를 했는데 맞을까요?
네네. 네네. 맞습니다.
아, 제가 이제 그 초기에 이제 몇달 전에 프로필 관리 처음 알게 돼서 했을 때 하다가 저는 모임이 생기니까 모임이 더 효과적일 거라고 생각했는데 약간 좀 모임이 좀 쓰면서 이게 그 반복 모임 설정을 해놓으니까 제가 게시글이 똑같은 게 계속 돌아다녀서 이게
네.
좀 곤란한 상황이거든요, 지금. 그래가지고 이거를 어떻게 정리해야 되나 했는데 오히려 모임방을 정리하고 프로필 관리 쪽으로 붙는 게더 좋겠다 이런 의견이신 거고. 그다음에 제가 궁금했던 건그 지금 말씀하신 것 중에 프로필 관리에서는 후기를 그냥 바로 이렇게 올릴 때마다 올린 사람들의 것이 쭉 보여지는 방식인데 모임에서는 후기를 어떻게 올려야 되는지 잘 모르겠더라고요. 그래서 혹시 아시나 해서 여쭤보고 싶습니다.
모임에서는 저도 후기를 다른 거를 잘못 봤던 것 같은데,
아, 예.
네. 쪽은 저도 관리를 그쪽 안 이쪽으로 넘어온 지좀 오래돼가지고 상세하게 기능을 다 기억하지 못하고 있습니다. 죄송합니다.
그러면 지금 말씀하신 거는 우리가 이제 일주일 단위로 레귤러 미팅을 하지만 일주일 단위로 뭐 소식을 올리고 싶으면 올리고 좀 이렇게 그 너무 많이 찾아오는 경우에는 좀 이렇게 텀을 두고 올리고
네.
어쨌든 와서 한번 그 단골이 된 사람한테는 우리가 소식 올릴 때마다 그 소식이 이제 알람 받기로 하면 다 가니까
네,
좀
맞습니다.
무리 없이 이 프로필 관리로만으로 해도 비즈니스 프로필 관리만으로 해도 우리가 전파력은 충분히 확보된다 이렇게 보면
네.
되겠네요.
그래서 그 지역에 어느 정도 사람들한테 도달할 수 있는 최대치, 이제 이런 것들을 대략 파악해 보는 것도 좋은 것 같아요. 이게 동네마다 좀 다를 것 같거든요. 얼마나 사람들이 이 당근 마켓을 집중적으로 사용하느냐, 안 하느냐에 따라서 지역마다 편차가 좀 있을 수 있어서 대략 어느 정도까지 도달하는지를 파악을 한번 해보시고, 일단 몇번 글을 올려보시면, 내 글이 어느 시점에 올린 게 얼마나 조회가 됐고, 얼마나 늘어나고 있고, 그런 것들을 조금 파악하시면 감을 잡으시는데 도움이 될것 같아요. 그리고 대략
아,
몇명 보면,
통계를
네, 확인을
분석해서
하면서,
활용해 보라는 말씀이신가 봐요.
대략 몇 명이 보면, 몇 명이 뭐 단골로 등록을 하고, 몇 명이 메시지를 보내는지, 그리고 그 중에서 몇명 정도가 모임에 참석을 하는지, 게스트로. 이런 것들을 대략적인 통계들을 보면 감이 좀 생기니까, 이후에 내가 어느 정도 수준으로 글을 올리면 되겠다라는 것들이 좀 생기실 것 같아요.
다음
한
질문 마지막으로
가지만
여쭤볼게요. 이
죄송하지만은,
당근으로
다음
사용하신 지가
질문으로
얼마나
넘어가도록
되셨나요?
하겠습니다. 케이트님, 요 조금 다른 분에게도 질문
다음.
기회를 주시면 좋을 것
에나님
같아요.
먼저 손 드셔서, 에나님.
감사합니다. 오늘 레슨 잘 들었고요. 질문이 하나 있는데요. 그 판교토마에서 이거 당근으로 하신 지가 얼마나 되셨는지 하고, 그 다음에 이걸 저희가 아까 관리자 추가된다고 하셨는데, 그 관리자 추가할 때마다 그 다른 오피서들한테 어떻게 핸드오버를 해주고 계시는지가 좀 궁금합니다.
네, 이거 쓰기 시작한 거는 저희 예전 VP PR 분이 만들어서 쓰시던 거를 좀, 쓰셨는데, 그때는 비즈니스 프로필 만들어서 광고까지도 했었어요. 근데 그때가 코로나 시기여서 광고까지 했지만 사람들이 많이 오진 않았거든요. 그러니까 온라인으로 참여하다 보니까 특히나 그랬던 것 같아요. 오프라인으로 참여하실 수 있는 코로나가 끝나기 시작한 작년 말 정도부터 좀 다시 본격적으로 조금 시작을 해서 그때부터 쓰기 시작을 했고요. 그때 처음 시작할 때는 저도 모임을 통해서 하다가 그 다음에 나중에 다시 비즈니스 프로필로 넘어가게 됐고요. 그리고 이 제가 이게 메뉴를 어느 메뉴에서 어떻게 핸드오버를 했는지 요거 캡처를 하진 않았는데 그렇게
네.
번거롭진 않았던 것 같아요. 그래서 당근마켓을 많이들 쓰시니까 그 비즈니스 관리자로 초대 메시지 같은 것도 보냈던 것 같아요. 누구를 이용해서 보내면 그분이 그 들어와서 관리할 수 있도록 하고, 뭐 제가 이제 그 역할을 VPPR을 안 하게 되면 이제 거기서 빠져나올 수도 있고, 그러니까 그분이 그 메인으로 관리하시는 매니저가 되면 나머지
네.
분은 좀 빠져나오는 것들이 크게 어렵진 않은 것 같아요. 근데 뭐 이분이 잘 안착해서 관리하실 수 있도록 도와주기 위해서 업적으로 들어가서 보시는 것들은 괜찮은 것 같고, 몇달 정도는 그러다가 잘 안착되시면 빠져나오셔도 되고, 이것들은 수월하게 왔다 갔다 할수 있는 것 같아요. 그거는 제가 요 링크에다가 캡처 화면을 좀 업데이트해서 공유를 드릴게요. 일단은 링크 드리면 이후에 내용 보실 수 있으니까, 업데이트한 내용들은 이후 제가 끝나고 나서 한 오늘 중으로 업데이트를 하도록 하겠습니다. 요 내용은 링크를 여기다 공유를 좀 해놓도록 하겠습니다.
감사합니다.
네.
한분 정도 더 질문 받을 수 있을 것 같고요. 세레나님.
네. 반갑습니다. 아놀드님. 또
네, 안녕하세요. 네.
예. 네, 제가 궁금한 게 이제 비즈니스 프로필에 보면은 이제 가격이랑 이게 보통 이제 서비스나 상품을 하는 거라서 거기에 가격이나 뭐 쿠폰 뭐 이런 거 올리는 게 있는데 사실 뭐 가격도 쿠폰도 사실 저희하고는 해당 사항이 별로
네.
없어가지고 가격은 저는 빵원으로 해놓고 쿠폰은 아예 등록은 안 했는데 여기 보면 많이 여기다 넣을수록 이제 노출이 늘어난다 했는데 특별히 뭘 하신 거는 없으신 거죠? 여기다가 저 쿠폰을
네.
어디 좀
요거를 직접 쓰진 않았던 것 같고요. 생각은 상상을 해봤습니다. 그냥 처음에 게스트분들한테 룸피 1,000원 할인 뭐 이런 걸 해줄까? 이런 생각을 정도는 했었는데, 예. 네. 그래서 넣어서 한번 실험해 보시는 것도 의미 있을 것 같습니다.
예, 그리고 또 하나는 제가 UI가 이게 좀 익숙하지가 않아가지고 벌써 COT 때 들었던 거를 실제로 한게한 2주, 3주 정도밖에 열흘밖에 안 됐어요. 이 비즈니스 프로필을 올린 지가 열흘 조금 넘고 모임도 아마 비슷하게 했는데
네.
모임에선 사실 조금 피드백이 와서 사람들이 좀 쌓여가지고 이번 주에
네.
우선인데 비즈니스 프로필은 아직 이렇다 할 효과를 못 보고 있는 게뭐 여러 가지 원인을 추적해 볼수 있을 것 같은데 지금 아놀드님 이야기를 들어보니까 사실 판교토마 같은 경우는 훨씬 전에 이거를 만들어놔서 그게 조금 안착이 돼서 그런 반응이 오는 게 아닐까라는 생각이 들어서 저도 비즈니스 프로필을 무시하지 않고 조금 계속 업데이트를 하면서 두 가지를 다 지켜보면서 해야 되지 않을까라는 지금 생각이 좀 드네요. 이게 케이트님한테도 좀 답이 될 것도 같은데 뭐 다른 분들도 마찬가지로
혹시 단골이 몇명 정도 있으신지 확인이 가능하신가요?
단골이 아직 없어요.
없어요? 네네.
오프만 가서 한 열흘밖에 안 됐기 때문에
네.
근데 모임에는 좀 선뜻 이렇게 와서 가입을 하시고 말은 안 걸어도 거기 남아 계시는데 단골은 아직은 없더라고요. 그래서 제가 너무 영어로 거기다가 많이 써서 그런 건지 진입장벽은 너무 높지 않게 한글로 써놔야겠다.
그래서 저희도 이것들을 적절하게 섞어서
네.
하고 있습니다. 요게 조금 몇번 시행착오를 거치면서 좀 최적화를 해 가고 있는 약간 포맷이긴 하거든요.
컨텐츠 큐레이션이 아마 좀 진입장벽을 처음에 낮게 만드는 게좀 주요할 것 같다는 생각이 좀 드네요. 네, 감사합니다. 네.
네, 이제 마무리를 해야 될것 같습니다. 네, 수고해 주신 아놀드님께 박수 부탁드리겠습니다. 화면 공유. 예. 다시 in English. 오케이. Next, we have someone who believes in the power of persistence. And I asked around how Shincheon Toastmasters is booming with new members these days. The answer to that question was her blogging. She's currently a member of Shincheon Toastmasters and also the district administration manager of District 93. It's my pleasure to introduce Lucy Lee.
Yes, thank you, training chair. Let me share my screen. Can you see?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Good evening. I'm Lucy from Shincheon Toastmasters. Today, I'd like to share my tips to gather more members through Naver Blog. You could say that I'm a Naver Blog evangelist. I didn't get paid by this company at all. The reason why I chose Naver for my blog was just, it's very simple. It's just commonly used in Korea. So the target of it is mostly Koreans. Even though its fame is fading, Naver is still a popular search engine in here, Korea. Due to this, to be honest, I hesitated a little bit when I got a suggestion to give a speech at the social media workshop because I didn't intentionally create my blog for Toastmasters. I didn't set any strategy or analytic plans to attract more guests or members to Toastmasters through my blog. Somehow, I decided to deliver a speech. I'm very honored to be here. I hope my tips can be helpful for your club to have more guests and members. Let me structure my speech as follows. First, its effect. In this initial part, I will share the conclusion and result of posting about Toastmasters on Naver blog. Second, my Naver blog. In the second part, you will explore my blog concept and content. Third, how to use it for Toastmasters. This part will show how to use blog for Toastmasters and invite people to Toastmasters meetings. Finally, strategies. In the last part, I will introduce four main keywords in blogging. You may be wondering how many people were invited to the meetings through the blog. I can't exactly remember the total number of people I've met and invited. I can't say the general or regular number of people either. I'm sorry, I'm not able to generate statistics. However, I can show you the recent number of Shincheon Toastmasters members I've invited through the blog. Now Shincheon Toastmasters has 21 members. Among them, 8 members are those whom I met and invited through the blog. 2 of them are now serving as club officers, and one of them holds the position of an area director. Then you can judge whether using the blog is effective or not. Now, let me introduce my blog. Here's the address of my blog, blog.naver.com/sodesign. I named my blog Hello Lucy, and its subtitle is English Life Blog, 영어 생활자 in Korean. As you can guess, the blog is about my life as an English learner as well as an English instructor at an institute. I opened the blog a long time ago. At the first couple of years, I posted randomly almost everything about my life, favorite music, favorite quotes, and my movie reviews, etc. Then there was no response. After setting up the concept and arranging the category, it started to show a good response as it had more neighbors. Neighbors here are like friends in this platform. With that being said, now all the content on my blog is related to learning English or my learning journey. The Toastmasters is one of them. This post is the most popular one with 7,646 views. It's about my review of student teaching when I was a graduate student. The second most popular one has 4,250 views, and it's about my review of middle school students' workbook. My blog has a unique feature that's different from other blogs. I can say my blog is interactive. Let's more dive into it. There is a list of recruiting study buddies. The first post in 2020 was aimed at gathering members to study online together, and it received 44 comments. After my first success in gathering members, I continued to organize diverse online study gatherings. To contact people, I use KakaoTalk. When they write a comment with their Kakao ID, I send them a message. Each study gathering doesn't last forever. It has a specific duration, usually 1 month. After completing the study, I post its review with words of appreciation. The members who study together often visit Shincheon Toastmasters. Some of them said, oh, Toastmasters is not my tie. But when study group members become Toastmasters, they often show a strong eagerness to attend meetings. Then let's move on to the third part, how to use it for Toastmasters. In the Toastmasters section, there have been 44 posts. The first post in 2019 was about introducing what Toastmasters is. And the second one was posted when I received the Best Speaker Ribbon. It was my first time. My initial post about Toastmasters mainly expressed my feelings and thought about Toastmasters. As time went on, I became more confident and started sharing my speech videos here. Ever since I became an officer, I started using my blog more strategically. I share this post, How to Become a Member, with guests, which includes all the information about membership. This post is the most popular one in the Toastmasters section of my blog, which has 913 views. Using the blog is very effective for sharing descriptions of functional role takers with both the guests and members. It's primarily for providing information about meeting roles. In addition, there is a post about the timer role. Moreover, an explanation about the icebreaker speech has been posted to help guests and new members understand their first speech. New members often feel puzzled about using the pathway, and their first speech can be threatening. This is why I share this post, and I find this post quite useful. Now I post the most diverse news about Toastmasters, including meeting minutes, a review of the debrief meeting, and the incoming officer training. I also promote Shincheon Toastmasters meetings through my blog, but not regularly. My future plan is to post about Mabok Toastmaster. I recently become a member of Mabok Toastmasters. To contact guests, I use the same way when I open a study gathering. I have people leave a comment with their Kakao ID, and then I contact them to invite into the Club Kakao chat. Finally, let me present the strategy in blogging. They could be main keywords and what you need in blogging. The catchphrase of Naver Blog is, with enough recourse, anything is possible. The phrase implies that it's getting worth posting over time. Promoting your club and attracting guests through your blog may not yield immediate results. It takes time, but its value gradually increases. Thus, blogging to promote your club needs to be continuous and persistent. Moreover, your blog should be interactive. Being interactive means that you need to consider your readers when you share a post. In addition, don't forget to respond to their comments as quickly as you could. Let me conclude my speech with questions and answers. Could you please ask me a question?
I have a question. Can I ask?
Oh, yes, Anna. Yes. Thank you.
I really like your blog. I think I'm kind of interested about your some kind of study activities too. But okay, I don't want to overcome. I don't want to make overcommitment. Anyway, so I think they are. I want to know the process of getting a become a Toastmaster forecast, meaning that they first come to your blog, and then they have a study, and then Toastmaster, and then they become a member. Or how do you talk to them? Because the blog is just blog. They come in, they can selectively get the information, right? So how do you do a sales speech for you to recruit your guest?
Well, Yes, actually, I just share my thought on my blog about Toastmasters, and many people leave comment and they say they want to join. They want to join the Toastmasters meetings. Then after finding their yes, and every post about Toastmaster says, yeah, if you are interested, and please leave your Kakao ID, then I will invite you. And people leave their Kakao ID, then I directly invite them to the club group chat.
I
And
see.
yes, I can get help from other officers and Shinjo Toastmasters members. And yes, regularly participate in the Toastmasters meetings, sometimes online and in person. Then yes, then they decide to become a member. And you know, the most important thing to change them to our members is actually it's not about blog, or that's just my opinion, and club's systematic, you know, meetings and officers' dedication. Yeah, those are more significant, I think, to have them as members.
Thank you so much. It was really helping to understand how it works. And then if you by any chance, can we promote our club in your blog too?
Oh, sure. And I post about, you know, Marco Toastmasters and also Visual Masters. Yes, when yeah, only when Serena asked me.
Okay, then I'll ask you about Chinese English bilingual Toastmasters.
Sure, sure.
Let's talk later. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Anna.
Ju Young had a question about the name of your vlog or blog, rather.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, I directly access my blog, so. Oh, yes, here's my. Yes, sorry, I can't use the chat room right now, so yes, here's the address of my blog.
Thank you.
Can I ask a question too?
Oh, yeah, sure.
It's a lot of information. Thank you. And if you want to, if you start a new blog as a BPPR or your own blog with Toastmasters, and then if you need to make a first page, so what would that be? What would be the good best for as a starter?
Well, if somebody wants to start open the new blog,
Yes, as a
well,
for Toastmaster
for
club.
Toastmasters, yes, probably the main keyword should be said like, yes, English learning for free. Even though we promote Toastmasters and the catchphrase needs to be related to English,
English.
learning English. Yes, people search English or learning English, then they find my blog. I as I've known.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank
And
you.
any other questions? Okay, let me check. So if there is no one, let's wrap up this session. And so let's give a thunderous applause to our presenter, Lucy. Thank you. Anyway, once I blog, I just posted just one blog a couple of years ago. Still, there are people who saw this post and reach us. That is the power of blogging. And let's move on to our next presenter. And okay, moving on to the vibrant world of Instagram. And I don't know much about Instagram, But I know everyone except me is doing Instagram. So if you want to attract more young generation guests, especially, this might be the way to go. She is the VPPR of Gachan Global Leaders Toastmasters. Give a warm welcome to Sumaya Ector.
Hello, everyone. Let me first share my screen. Is it visible?
Yes.
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 So, hello, everyone. This is my honor to be here today. And I will try to help, like, I will try to tell you my strategies and how I started this and what's the result out of this. But I cannot see the timer. Can I have 1 second, please? Let me just set this first. Yeah. So here, is there anyone who have any problems with my voice or anything? Is it clear for everyone?
Yes, very clear.
Thank you so much. So I'm a student of Gachon University. Right now, it's my second year. And I would love to talk about more about Instagram and our Toastmaster. And without further delay, let's get into this video. I mean, let's get into this session. So I have a question. How many of you are using Instagram? Can I have a raise? Can I have a raise? Ooh, okay. Okay. I see a lot of people raising their hands. And I have one more question. Are you guys using it regularly or how often you guys are using it? Is it daily, monthly, ever? Like, how often? Can I have few sounds out of here? Is there anyone who is willing to talk?
Not daily, but I think like bi-daily or three days once, something like that. Yeah.
Okay. Quite often. Thank you for your response. So for me, if I have to share about my experience, I am using it quite often. I can tell every day. And I think it's been normal for all the like young generations. And I think if there is something called social media, the first thing came to our mind or comes to our mind is Instagram. And which is pretty much normal, I guess, because it's more convenient to use. So I will be telling you how it works and how it's going on right now for us and our Toastmaster. Here, as you can see, I will be telling you the difference between both like Facebook and Instagram. Why? Because I think most of the people are using Facebook now and it is very common. How many of you are using Facebook? Are you guys using it most like quite often? Okay, because it's been a while that it has been published and people are using it quite often because they think it's easier. But when there is a lot of ways that you can use Instagram and, you know, can make it happen either way, like in Facebook and Instagram, you can put both together and you can see the difference between them. But there is a lot of issues recently or back then it was. But I would like to show you brief ones that's been like, when it comes to Facebook, there is a lot of political manipulation, I would say. And advertisement is free in Facebook. When I say that, when you're watching a video, you will see that the advertisement, they just pop up in your page out of nowhere. You are watching a video and they will just disturb you, like, because it's a grab at like taking your attention from there, I would say. And at the same time, Facebook is not secure. It's not secure. When I'm saying that, when you're posting something, it goes out of no, like, if you are not putting that only private, then it will be going to the people, those who are not connected to you. So it's really wide and it's not even secure. But when it comes for Instagram, it's really easy. So when I ask to you guys that, do you think it's easy or not? Or how many people of you guys are using Facebook? I saw a lot of raise, but when it comes for Instagram, I saw there was not. So because they don't know why we have to use Instagram. So let me tell you something about Instagram. Is it's really easy to use and post. Because in Facebook, you have to post, like go to your profile and then you have to choose you want to go for a story or post. It's there is a lot of steps that you have to go through. But in Instagram, it's not. It's pretty much easier than Facebook. And it's more secure and easy to manage. So those who are super busy with their life, it's really easy to manage that. Okay, today I'm going to use like 40 minutes and you can just do your own work because there is no advertisement. Like there is no attraction grabbers and there is nothing that's coming to your path. And the story features in Facebook, if I say, if you go there, there will be like few filters that you can use for your pictures and those are really limited. But in Instagram, there is a lot and there is a lot more stickers or something that you can post for your own post and that will grab someone's attention pretty much easily. So that's why I'm saying that Instagram is way more easier to manage and way why you should use the Instagram rather than Facebook. It's way more easier. I just told you about it. But here is the thing that how can you make a post? How can you make a post? It's really easy and simple. When you go, how many of you have Instagram? I think there is half of the people here having Instagram. And as Annalie said, she is using it quite often. She must have an account in Instagram, right? So when you have an Instagram account, you will always have a page like called feed. And without, let me just show you a picture. I think, okay. Normally posts are like this. Let's have a look at the picture. Normally posts are like this. So there will be something like that. And you keep scrolling and scrolling, you will be getting the pictures and everything. But how you post it, you will have a sign like plus sign in the beginning of the page, in the front page. And there, if you click that one, you will be going to your own gallery where you have your pictures and you can choose your pictures and you can choose up to 9. That means the total picture can be 10 pictures. And you can attach them all together. And here, there is a strategy of getting more views. And you can know that you're getting more views than like before. How you do that? You can look at the story or make a story before, you know, after posting something, you can make a story so that you can check the viewers. So how you make a story, here you can see after posting any picture, there you will be having a sign. As you can you see my mouse?
Yes.
So when you have this, right? When you click here, you will be having a page like that popping up like that here. So here there is a sign, right? Plus sign. So when you click here, it goes to your story. And here, as you can see, how many likes I do have. I have only 14 likes in my post, right? But when it goes for story, there is 26 views, which is impressive because people sometimes just skip your post because they don't want to get the related videos for the whole time. So sometimes they just skip it. But for the story, they watch it. And there is some people out there who don't want to be showed up. So they just can contact you through the story. That's way more easier, I would say. And after that, here, as you can see, the posting is quite easy. And making story, as you see, is easy. So when you get the viewers here, you can make sure that, okay, I am having this much people and they're contacting with you. And that's how you can make a post, a story. And you can check your viewers, how it's going on, how well it's going on, or what you can like improve on your account or what you have to do. And here's the marketing. There is a strategy how you do it. And here's a big picture of ours, of our GGLTM Toastmaster group. So here's the way you can grow your page or grow your whole thing. Here I will be saying how you do it. First, use hashtags. So using hashtag helps you to grow. How? Because there's people sometimes we go through something like, as you see, I think most of the are we are in Korea, right? So let's take an example for Coupang. So when we search something like maybe a food, that can be anything. So when we see like maybe a ramen, right? So when we see a ramen, beside that, there is a lot of more links that coming up. Like, okay, this one has been the most sold out, or this one is the most, what's that? In high, like maybe rankings, people bought it the most. So how it happens? It happens because of the linkings. And most of the time, because of the hashtags. And the high quality images. So when it comes for Facebook, you cannot use their post. You like, if you're posting any pictures, it goes bad way, like it fades away the picture sometimes. But when it comes for Instagram, it doesn't happen to you, your post. And share at the right time. So if your viewers are just watching them on, you know that your viewers are like maybe 30s or students, you can understand by looking at the post or somehow maybe going and looking, look up to their post and maybe their profiles, you will understand that what they are, who they are. So if they're students, most of the time, the people I have in my account right now, I find that most of them are students and they are normally free on Saturday or Sunday. So I generally post my pictures or attachments on Saturday or Sunday so that I can grab their time, I can grab their attention, and they can provide me with some of the, you know, informations if they have any questions. And also, like, don't afraid to post multiple times. What I mean to say, I post every week 3 times, but for the story, I constantly keep making a story so that I can keep them updated that, okay, next day we are doing that. If there is someone who wants to join, they may contact us or they feel free to join, because sometimes people are pretty much scared to go and ask you, but it's better to you go first and ask them to come and invite them. They feel more welcome. So yeah. And at the same time, ask questions. You can ask questions if what are they doing or what's their plan coming, or if they want us to improve something in our page. So that makes sense, because that helps you to understand, like, okay, they are trying to help us, so we can help them by giving some feedbacks. And it's always both sides. It's not like one-sided. And use automatic web tools. What I mean by that, sometimes you can just use some of the apps to edit your picture to make it look pretty and better. And that's how you can help to grow your Toastmaster page or your Instagram page. And here is something that when you are gonna post, and as I said that your audience mostly active in the morning, then you have to post afternoons, like before the day, because our posts keep looping. It doesn't go off, or it doesn't just, you know, vanish. So it just keep looping. So if you're posting like before the day, the next day, if they're opening the feed, that the first thing it will be popping up is your post. So make sure you're doing that and post during quiet times, because right now in Instagram, we have quiet time. Like, there is a limitations. The user can really do that. If it's like 12, until 12, you want to keep it. It will be until after 12, there will be no text coming to you. So you can post on the quiet time, and the time they will wake up or they will open up their feed, it will be just popping up. And one or two per day is enough. When I say that, you can do it most often, but I do it every week 3 times, which is, I think, enough. And 15 posts on weekly basis is ideal. So posts can be on your story and your post and your like real post that's gonna be in your feed. But as I have to tell you, one thing is when it's come for story, it will be only staying there for 24 hours. So after 24 hours, you can post many more if you want. And yeah, so beware of your statistics. As I said, you can see your views, that how many people watched your story. And what you can post in your Instagram, you can post a picture. You can post anything you want, but connected to your theme, connected to your like subject that, okay, you are maybe advertising of some kind of food. So you will be posting a picture of your food. So as I am advertising or I am trying to collect people from Instagram, so what I'm doing is I'm posting a picture every single week. And as we all know, a picture or 1,000 words. So instead of using a lot of words, it's better you just show them a picture. And it should be something short, clear, and maybe precise text, which is high quality. As you can see here, guess who is the speaker? So that time we had a speaker and I just wanted to, you know, show him up. So I just put the status saying like, guess who's the speaker? Just attention grabber. And beside that, as you can see down there, if you're looking for a place, so it's just something I post every single time when I'm posting, because that's the rule of our page. And the hashtag that you're saying, every time we're posting with the same hashtags, because we are the we are under Gachon University. So our main attraction is Gachon students. So here we have the hashtags, as you can see. And here you can see that, okay. Oh, can I have 1 second? Okay. So here, how you will be getting the feedback. So define your objects. Comments are a good way to meet your audience. So create a safe environment, ask questions. So there's a lot of text, don't look at this. Just you can do one thing is when someone is commenting on your post, try to reply and try to ask them some other questions as well. If there is something they want to talk about, you can ask them to like contact you in the inbox. So that's a safe place and only you and the user is understanding or you know, trying to contact with each other, trying to solve the problem or trying to give information to each other. That is a good way to give feedback and take feedback. And creating a safe environment, who doesn't want it? So you better do it. That's how you will be growing faster, I would say. And other than that, while doing this, we got 2 members. Like they were guests. We get a lot of guests very often. And but before that, I want to say that recently, I got 3 guests to join maybe upcoming our meetings, but I have 2 records that they were our guests and they are now our regular members, and they we were introduced with each other from here in Instagram, and that was it was a good chance to get them, and they are right now our regular members, as you guys can see. And that was it, that you can also get members from here, and you can also tell people that what you're doing, and that is way more easier than any other platform, I would say. So yeah, thank you. Is there any questions?
I have a question.
Kate.
Oh, let Kate go first. Okay.
Yeah.
Please turn on your mic, Kate.
Oh, there you are. Thank you, Scott, for yielding. Thanks for your presentation, Sumaya. I wonder what is your track record of success? So can you tell me about the following you have and the conversion rate in percentage? Thank you.
Oh, yeah. So as I have already said, that the people we are getting from here is not that much huge, because I think not all of us or a lot of people know about our page, but we are trying to, you know, advertise it, and we are trying many other ways. But from here, I guess I would say, as you asked for the percentage, for now, I think I cannot say the exact one. But recently, the people we have, I think we have more than 10 members right now. But among them, we have 2 or 3 of them from Instagram, who are from Instagram.
So 20% success rate, yes?
Yeah, I can say that.
Thank you.
Yeah. Sumaya, do you have to post the hashtags every time, or is this one time enough and they just keep repeating and recycling?
No, you have to post this in every post so that just you want to see, you want people to see your all the posts, not just one post. So that's why when you're posting in only one post that hashtag this, that one only will be viral or just going to others' feed. But it's better to post in every because you want your post to be seen like both times, like every and each. So in that case, you have to use your hashtags for every post.
So every time I have to write new copy and paste new hashtags. Okay.
Thank you for your question.
I have a question. Does it allow uploading short video or multiple pictures as well?
Yeah. So as I think you are using Facebook. And in Facebook, there is a new feature called Reels or short videos. But in Instagram, there is also called Reels, where you can post small videos. And there is three parts of that. In first feed, when you go into your page, as let me show you this. So when you log in, you get a page like this. That's all about your pictures. But as you can see here, a box of video, something like that, right? So here your videos will be showing. They have structured. It's structured that in pictures, videos, and there will be something that you already achieved. So here you can post any video, anything you want, and that will be popping up here. And this session is for only pictures. Mm-hmm. And it's way more easier and better than Facebook because you can use a lot of more other additional things that can be new stickers, that can be new musics and any other viral thing that's going on now.
So while users are, how do I say, scrolling through the Instagram page, they mm-hmm. are there when there was there are lots of pictures, among them also your videos are there, or does it have separate page?
Well, sometimes it just comes up all together, but mostly it doesn't, because there is a page. If you are going here, this page is only for videos. There is not really a lot of pictures, and here this place is only for your, you know, posts, and like all together will be coming, but mostly if you want to see only videos, then you may go here and you will be getting like specific videos that you are searching for, you were looking for. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I think our time's up. Thank you, Sumaya. So let's give a thunderous applause to Sumaya again. And moving on to next presenter. Let me check the time. Okay. Please. Let me find our presenter first. Next presenter. Where is Kelly?
I'm here.
Okay. While I was on the hunt for our workshop's presenter, I saw that South River Toastmasters were trying every channel out there, right? Kakao Open Chat, Instagram, Meetup, to Facebook and YouTube. So they are doing it all, literally. I just had to find out who was behind this magic. So this person has won many hats as the club president, VP at South River Toastmasters, and also as an area director. to name a few. So please join me in welcoming Kelly Kim.
Good evening, everyone. So I think everyone here are really passionate about growing your club. And you made this time on Sunday night to learn about how to grow your club with the new social media plan. So yeah, so I try to make your time more precious as much as I can. I'm a member of a South River Toastmaster, and I've been a member since 2015. So I've been a long member of South River Toastmaster. And let me share my screen. So we're back to offline meeting in last year, February. So when we came back to offline meeting, it was pretty bad. Like we had like five attendees. A lot of our members and guests had to take like, you know, double roles. And SRTM used to have like 40 members. So I didn't suffer from that before. And then after COVID, like when we were back from like Zoom, we were taking double roles and had really hard times. So we had an officer meeting. We had to find a way to be back to where we used to be. And then we started like Somoim and Meetup and like several medias, and we were able to make more members and guests. And then guests and members grow, so we moved to the bigger room. So now we are kind of struggling again, but I think we find a way to how to make, you know, like guests coming to SRTM and then make them members as well. So what I wanted to emphasize today is that we have to frequently update our social media plan, because I think things are changing really fast. So what we used to do before, like 5 years ago, is not working these days in today. So in SRTM back in the days, we used to use like Facebook. We even did the Facebook ads, and then it brought a lot of members and guests before. And then we did a meetup. It worked really well before, but I don't think meetup works well as better as before. And then we did also Instagram and YouTube as well, as Hongsa mentioned. So kind of this, we did some kind of ads with the video clip and yeah, meetup. That's what we did before COVID-19. And then during the COVID-19, we still use meetup and Facebook to bring more people. However, it didn't really work. So we had an officer meeting on how to improve guest influx to the meeting. And then if you search on the search engine, Google, Naver, so you will see that like there are a lot of blog, like Lucy mentioned, talking about the Toastmaster. So we were brainstorming what we should do, like, and then these are things that we came up with. Like we have to optimize search engine and then make a blog posting, and then let's open Somoim. However, our members are not that like diligent enough, so we didn't do blog. I think blog, as like we need a like a member like Lucy who put a lot of efforts and a lot of yeah, power to continue the blog, but we didn't have that kind of a gifted member. So so we tried to make our South River Toastmasters page right, because when a lot of guests search from the search engine and then find our club from Toastmasters homepage. So what we first did was update our Toastmasters information page. We updated location, time, and also website. So this website is one of the important part of for us because we lost our website a long time ago. So we made a new website that I'm going to talk about soon. So the plan that we came up with was these three. So let's do Kakao open chat, and then let's do Somoim, and let's open a Linktree. Linktree means the website. It's a, as you can see, it's a page that you can add a lot of several websites to the link. So in our case, we added our Kakao open chat link and also Somoim link as well. So it's all interconnected. I think it's really important to connect all these people together so that we know that like people are asking questions and people are people know where they should ask questions, things like that. So let me start with Somoim. Have you ever tried Somoim before? Like, yeah, some people, yes, some people didn't. I didn't really try Somoim before, so it was new to me. However, I found this Somoim app really useful. Like they did a lot of gathering apart from like English club like us. But at Somoim, if you from the guest perspective, if you are interested in speaking in English and you know delivering speech, you will probably click here, right? Language, and then once I click here, I could see our club very on the top, yeah. And then you couldn't find anything specific, you can check here, right? So all these things are what you can configure in your like setting of your club. You can choose which part of interest that your club is in, and then which language that your club is using. All this you can configure. That's why, as you can see here, there is Kyude Toastmaster, GDTM, and yeah, as well. So let me show our club's page. So I didn't really mention that this is a Toastmasters club in Somoim. Because I didn't think that people know what Toastmaster is. So mentioning about what Toastmasters is too early stage, to give information in the Somoim map. So I briefly mentioned that our club is all about self-development, communication skill, public speaking, and also English skills. Mm-hmm. And then also I briefly explain how our meetings are going on. So I think this information is enough for our guests to see what this club is about. And then if they happen to come to our club, they will know more about what Toastmasters is. And also in Somoim, you have to set up a weekly meeting. There UI UX is not really user friendly, so you have to make your meeting every week, every click. Yeah, so you have to be diligent to set up your meeting. So our meeting is next Wednesday. So if you're interested in participating, so please let me know, and then you can update your agenda here. I'm very lazy, so I didn't update the agenda after October 11, but it's better to update the agenda every week so that guests can know what our meeting is going to be. And actually, I was really surprised to see like how many people actually enter this Somoim club and then ask question about our club. So I yeah, explain briefly about when our meeting is going to be and where. And then if they ask me any question, I answer in detail.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yeah, next plan, as I mentioned before, is Kakao open chat room. I think a Kakao open chat room, I think it's a very good method for us to link our potential guests to our members and our officers. So whenever like someone like search our club from here, and then like contact to our president, our president always give our Kakao chat room link, so that they can get information from here, not from, you know, like other area, other homepage or, yeah. And within our Kakao chat room, there is also Linktree that you can get a lot of information about. There's also Kakao chat room, and then we show where the venue is. And also we added a Facebook group, and then also SRTM in Toastmaster International website, and this website as well. I think these are the list of things that we thought it's enough for our guests if they want to know further about SRTM or Toastmaster.
Mm-hmm.
So overall, I think what we did like to make our guest inflows to the club is we open Somoin to get more like newcomers. And then we use this Kakao open chat to answer to the questions and make them come and give more like friendly contact to our guests. And then we use the Linktree to give them like detailed information. That's all we did. And my suggestion is, if you want to actually plan to have a lot of guests, what we did is we plan open house. Like open house meaning like you can, in our term, we don't get like room fee for the day, and then we book a big room and then invite our previous members and announce everywhere. And also ask our guests and members to invite, you know, friends, so that many people, we give opportunity to many people to join the club and see and experience what Toastmasters is. Mm-hmm. And with that event, I think like sometimes like in the middle of the weeks or months, we were able to like gain a lot of guests, and then they were able to also transfer members. So yeah. That's all for me. If you have any question, please ask any question.
Mm-hmm. I have a question.
Yep.
Yes, mm-hmm. I'm Jin from Bundang Toastmasters. So when you use Somoim service, do you pay for the service?
Yeah, we pay. It's it's 15,000 won per month.
Oh, I see. Thank you.
Yeah, it's worth.
Okay.
I have a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yes. So for the open chatting room, Kakao open chatting room.
Yeah.
You have all the members there as well, or just the guests and the VP, any officer who is greeting them?
We have all the officers.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's not just, you know, VPE or VPM who is answering to the question. Anyone who is available, like, you know, greet guests and answer to the question.
Okay.
So, I think if you make it, you know, one person's, you know, responsibility, that becomes a lot burden to that person, right? So,
right.
Yeah.
And once a guest becomes a member, do they go to, like, do you have a separate, you have a separate Kakao room for them, right?
We have a separate member Kakao chat room.
Mm-hmm.
Where people have a more context of what Toastmasters is, what our, you know, club is about. Mm-hmm. Whereas in this chatting room, I think not many people have that much context about what's going on. So what I do here is I do give information about, you know, the roles so that people can check out.
Mm-hmm. And do the guests, after they come like a couple of times, do they become a member or leave the room?
No, I don't think they left the room.
Oh, they just stay. Okay.
No, it's you know, up to them, you know, who just stay there or leave the room. Okay. I haven't seen many, you know, members who actually left the room. Just
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, if you don't have any question, I'll wrap up. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's give a thunderous applause to Kelly Kim again. We are all done with our presenters, and okay. Let me check the agenda first. Let me check. We have more time to.
We have 12 minutes left
until
for recognition and group photo.
Because Katie.
Kate
mentioned that she wants to talk about something. About her idea. Kate, can you? You have like 2 minutes. Is it okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, okay.
Hello, everyone. I am here to provide one idea that really works well in the community that I'm involved in at Stanford Graduate School of Business. So allow me to share that. And then if you guys can, you know, maybe if you integrate it, I hope this could be a success. So from what I see of all the presenters, you guys have great ideas, but they're all fragmented. So we need to bring them together. And here is, I'll share you my screen. Okay, so welcome to Stanford Graduate School of Business online community. And we use Workplace. Have you heard of Workplace? And we use Workplace as a collaborative tool to gather everybody who studied at Stanford to co-create a sub-community. So for imagine, you unite the Korean Toastmasters under one umbrella of Workplace, and then sub-communities, i.e. example, your Toastmaster, your branch can plug in and create within that umbrella. So here is an idea. This is where everybody gathers, right? There's 5,000 of us. So imagine you guys are all gathering in one umbrella called Workplace, and then you guys can create your own chapter. And then you can cross-collaborate. As a person, I can go here to one Toastmasters in Bundang. I can go here, another Toastmaster in Gwanghwamun. Like, I can hop around, right? But I'm always doing the same thing, learning how to speak. So this is one idea. I hope this could be helpful for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate. We might have to look into more details later. But it was good information. And I think it's time to move on to our next session. And first of all, thank you to all our amazing presenters. And let's take a moment to show our appreciation for their contributions. And our presenter certificates, we prepared and take a photo with each presenter, as always. And okay. Ah, not good food. Our first presenter is... No. Sorry. Arnold Cho. Arnold, are you there?
He's coming.
Okay.
Sorry.
Let's go. Okay. I'm not sure the certificate is pinned or not. In my screen, only Arnold. Is the certificate pinned to your screen?
I don't know what you mean by pinned, but I can see it.
If you can see it, it's okay. But in my screen, I cannot take a picture with only. That is the problem. There are more. Okay.
I can help to capture the screen.
Yeah. If you could, thank you. Because in my screen, I have more, more people in my screen.
So with the certificate and honor only, or
honored
with you?
Me.
Could you pin both of you? I can pin.
I've already done that, but
really,
I'm really sorry. Let me do this. It doesn't work in my screen. I cannot do it.
But the thing
there's no me in your screen, right?
Yeah, only honor and certificate.
Can you just say, it's okay for me to not to be included.
Okay, then I will just capture honor and certificate.
Honored, okay.
Okay. Could you smile, honor?
Yeah.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. Click. Okay, I did. I made it.
Okay, thank you. And next, Lucy. Where's Lucy? Lucy. Okay. Yes, Sarah.
Okay, where's Lucy? Okay, I found her. Okay, one more. 1, 2, 3, smile. I made it.
And Sumaya. Oh, there. Are you seeing Sumaya?
Yeah, I found her. Okay. 1, 2, 3, smile. Oh my god. What is the balloon? Okay, one more time. 1, 2, 3, smile. I made it.
You almost there. And Kelly.
Kelly, okay, I found her. 1, 2, 3, smile. I got it.
And I'm not sure you can do this, but you have to take. In my case,
own photo?
I was not able to. Yeah.
Okay. Where is me? Okay.
That was the difficult part.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. I got it.
Oh, okay, thank you. And for me, there's one for me. It was to be presented by Scott.
Great job. Outstanding job, Hung San.
Okay, Hung San. One, two, three, smile. Yeah, I got it.
Thank you, Sarah.
My pleasure.
Okay, it's time to take a group photo. I think I can handle this. Okay, we have to take a, we have like 40 people. We have to take a couple of, but would you please turn on your video so that I can take a picture? We have to take pictures at least two times. So let me do this, the first one. So smile, smile. And I took the first shot. Let me save this. Okay. Next shot. One, two, three. Okay, I think it's done. Thank you, everyone.
And thank you, Hung-san, for all of your work.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, not only did you arrange the recruiting, you managed the rehearsals, you managed the agenda, you managed the session, and did a pretty good job at Zoom for your first time. Yeah. One more round of applause for Hung-san and all of our trainers. Thank you.
Arnold, thank you.
Maya, Kelly, wonderful job. And thank you, Sarah, for timing and being back up Zoom. Everybody helped each other. And thank you, Kate, for your suggestions as well. Okay. I'll back to you, Hung-san, if there's anything you have to say.
We will share the, what is that, material, like a PPT or anything in the District 93 homepage. You can do it, right? Okay, thank you everyone. That was all.
Have a good night.
Yeah, have a good night, everyone.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, bye-bye.
Bye-bye, bye-bye, everyone.
고생하셨어요, 형사님.
아, 네, 아유 감사합니다. 예, 와주셔서 감사합니다. 예.
Pretty good turnout, Hung-san. Yeah, not bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, minus the six or seven of us, and then about 40 or so. So.
Yeah.
Well done.
Thank you. Yep. I did not expect that many people come.
Yeah, and that's pretty good for. Just getting started like 2 weeks before as far as advertising the event. So yeah, wonderful. The next time, I think, for our next session.